Right on here, I'm for it. I believe a number was hovering. Punk sitting on, look at the lines, I just poured up. Got cameras, we see them, they can't see the truck boy. They run no truck for that money and hold you for ransom. I need help, I got a problem. I'm inside his grandson. From the crack to coke to the bar to smoke, I get my hands on. She thought I was cooking food, I fed her with my pants on. Give her a young. Get my head. Which one you working? Watch who you serving. They hit you back and forth before I do the urban. I could have bought that, but I bought a chain for 30. Got 27 stuff that get it who's a burden. I'ma chase that paper till I'm tired. Nigga had a risk. They made this car, you still die. They had a vest. Hope you proud of me. Nobody made it from my project yet. I signed a deal in my city on a private jet. I'm a figure, I ain't never fitting.
We back with another episode of the Randy Wilson Podcast. I'm your host, Randy Wilson. This is episode 82, and I have the distinct pleasure today to have the youngest guest I've ever had on the show. He's not only the youngest guest, but don't allow age to really define him, because he is the number one player in the country in the fifth grade. The number one player in the country. This is King Bacot. And I am just very excited to have the pleasure to sit down and talk with him today. We have his manager slash mother slash, you know, agent alongside us here, Joya. And so we may have to get some other perspective on a few questions today. But King, you destined for greatness, brother, with the name that you have. Your parents knew what they were doing when they created you. And I just want to say to you that, you know, I was talking to my son right before this show, and I said, you know, I'm about to talk to a, I told him he was 10, but 11-year-old, he said, he's not 10. I said, you sound like you hating, man. This kid is the number one player in the country in the fifth grade, and the future is extremely bright. And so just happy to have you on the show. Shout out Jacobs Creek Elementary School, Chesterfield County. Shout out the Dream Chasers United, the AAU squad that has been making a name for themselves. Because this young brother, if I'm correct, has a few national championships. Am I right with that? He also has a few MVPs. How many MVPs you have? Are you the MVP of every game, every tournament you play in, typically?
There was one time where I did that.
Yeah. But you're used to winning at this age. You've got used to it, and that's a great habit. You can't shout out all the schools and teams that he played for, though, without shouting out the parents, because they've groomed this young man to be in the, you know, he's still a kid. I don't even want to say young. He's still a kid, man. He's 11 years old, but they've groomed him. And they've not only groomed him, but this young kid, man, comes from a lineage of athletes. If I'm correct, and correct me if I'm wrong, your sister is a basketball player for Virginia State University. Your brother, Armondo Bacot, is a standout basketball player at the University of North Carolina, which is why I put the jersey on today. This is my old throwback Ed Cota jersey that I ain't proud to say it, but I stole it when I was about your age out the locker room. I ain't proud to say it, but yeah, man. I mean, this kid is, you know, great. The future is bright for you. Like, without a shadow of a doubt, all your brother has to do is stay healthy, and he's gone. He's gone to the NBA.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this. What is it like? I mean, you're coming up and you're seeing your brother and your sister excel at a high level in their sport. Can you tell me, like, what have they been like? Can you describe the example that they provided for you?
It's a great example. You know, I'm just gonna say this. I'm still better than you. But you know, we're not gonna spend too much on that. They're bums to me.
Say that again.
They're bums to me. They, you know, they're better than people they play, but they're not better than me.
Oh wow! So you kind of got like that LaMelo Ball type of attitude, I guess. In your mind, you believe that you're better than your brother and your sister, huh?
Yes. Yes, sir.
But when y'all play one-on-one, what happens?
I would beat them.
Randy.
I'm not
he
even.
He can't beat me, though.
That's a
Never, ever. Listen, he don't like to lose. I go outside, and it's like, Mom, that's cheating, that's cheating. So I said, okay, let's go back again. I said, let's go back again and do it one more time. And I still beat him, and he still hate to lose.
Well, you know what, though? I guess the attitude, though, works for you, man. I mean, you know, I grew up playing basketball, and I played in college. And, you know, I think the one thing that separates good from great is, you know, having that attitude, that determination to just want to be the best. And even if you know somewhere down deep inside that maybe someone got an edge on you, you really don't want to – you ain't going to allow yourself to believe it, are you? When did you pick the basketball up for the first time?
When I was 1 year old.
One.
Yeah.
How did you introduce the ball to him, Mom?
He ain't been around it for a long. I mean, he's just been around basketball, the gym. He bounced it, been in the gym, bouncing it with the teams. He's been playing up for a while, but I remember the times King, you know, he was just there. He played the background. He was on a team. He was on the AAU team, actually. And, you know, he didn't play much. He never played much. He got in, but not much. But he was still younger than everybody, too. So, yeah, so he, I don't know. It was just being around the young. And you got to think, too, brother and sister, they play. So I got a two-year-old little girl. I hope she don't want to play. Because that's all she see and do.
Well, you can't say you hope she don't want to play. I mean, she got to follow in the footsteps.
Yeah, that's true. But, you know, maybe we could do golf or tennis or something.
Hey, well, there'll always be a time for that. You better take advantage of those knees and ankles and back while you got them. That's King, true. I've been watching your game on the internet and through friends of mine that have it, you know, the Assist Basketball League. I've heard a lot about you from Coach Carter.
That's a great guy.
Coach Harris, Manny Harris, Blacktop Kings of Queens. Like, I got my ear to the street when it comes to the basketball. I've coached a lot. And so I've watched your game. And who are you influenced by? Like, who inspired you? Like, who do you watch on TV?
I watch mostly KD, but my favorite player is Steph Curry.
Steph Curry is your favorite player? Do you try to pattern your game after Steph Curry?
No, not at all.
So, like, what contributes to the creativity in your game?
Kevin Durant.
Yeah.
It's so much like Kevin Durant.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're a hater.
Say that again.
Say otherwise, you're just a hater.
Yeah, Kevin Durant is. I would say you would think that Kevin Durant's the best player in the league.
LeBron's too old.
So, I mean, why are we making LeBron? Why does it got to be have to do with age, though? Why does his age have to do?
Better than him at the moment.
Excuse me?
All time, he's better. But
at this immediate moment, you don't think so? You've been watching basketball for a few years. When do you think LeBron went from number one to number two? Like, or number three. I know you may think he's number three, but when did you think he came off of it?
2020, when he got injured.
Yeah. That's fair. It's just, we haven't been able to see. It's just been, it's been interesting since the bubble. Like, we haven't really been able to see a full, good, healthy season. I'm a Laker fan, by the way, though. What's your favorite team?
Really? Golden State.
I imagine. I'm a Laker fan and I'm a Charlotte Hornet fan. King, let me ask you this. I think that without a shadow of a doubt, if you continue on the path you're on, your future is extremely bright. What do you think that you have to do to stay on the right path so that you can play in the NBA?
Stay focused.
What does that mean to you?
Like, in a way, you know how, like, people will go out and do the wrong thing sometimes?
Yeah.
I can do that.
Good. I take it that you listen to your parents.
Yes.
You recognize that they are obviously invested in your best interest. You know, that's the difference between a lot of kids who make it and those who don't. Do you take school serious?
Yes.
Do you understand the importance of your education right now?
Yes, I do.
You know, it's more than just A's and B's. The discipline and focus that it requires you to have to be committed to something is the same type of focus and commitment that translates over to, like, you know, being a successful athlete. Let me ask you this. Would you skip college to go to the NBA if you had the opportunity?
Yes.
Yep. However, if you had to go to college, what school would you go to?
Oklahoma State.
Oklahoma State. Why would you go to Oklahoma State? Who do you know from Oklahoma State that has inspired you to want to go there?
Who? Cade Cunningham.
King Cunningham?
Cade.
KD? I can't hear you.
Cade Cunningham.
I don't know that kid. Is he play for them?
Cade
Cunningham. Who is that?
The number one pick in the draft this year.
Oh, okay, my bad. I'm sorry. Listen, I'm a big basketball fan, but I'm not gonna lie. College basketball the past couple of years, it's like he got drafted by like Detroit. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know you're talking about. I watched him, but I've not been impressed. And this has been a major. This was supposed to be a big draft, so I'll see what this game is like in the NBA. But I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm one of the biggest basketball fans of any of my friends, people know, right? But I just find college basketball, I don't find it as fun as the NBA. What do you like watching the most, college or NBA?
I like watching my brother more than the NBA.
Of course.
College is trash.
Who?
College is trash.
But
that's why I'm not going.
So, would you rather go to the G League, I guess, if you had to do something else?
The draft, not the G League.
Got you. What do you think about LaMelo Ball?
I like how he plays basketball. He's not like a shoot first guy. He likes to pass more than he shoots.
Are you a shoot first guy?
Not really.
No?
It depends. If it's like the end of the game. Not in the
you enjoy getting your teammates open and getting them the ball. You like the easy basket.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So because you like Steph Curry though. So do you shoot a bunch of threes?
He had to shoot. He couldn't pass it to Klay Thompson, so he had to shoot the ball. But
he been shooting his whole life. He ain't never saw a shot he didn't like.
He has. Many times, I think.
Steph Curry is an interesting person though. Like he didn't have, I remember growing up as a kid being at the same basketball camps as Steph Curry. Like he wasn't nowhere good like what he's grown to be. You know, he had a lot of heart and a lot of determination. He went to Davidson. It's not a big school. You know, that's where I grew up at. So. Trust me, he didn't get in the NBA because of passing, that's for sure. It didn't hurt to be the son of Del Curry either, to have, you know, some opportunity.
Yeah. I'm gonna tell you, like, I like watching King play. Have you seen a few of his videos, Randy?
Oh yeah, I've watched all of them.
Okay. Like he I don't know, it's just to act cute to me to be so young. Of course, being around it for so long, but it's like he's a natural. And if he ain't got nothing down pat, he got the basketball down pat. It's a blessing though. I mean, to be number one at a young age and in the nation, and that's not because I said so, or he said so, or you said so. It's like, you know, it's the vote, you know, and it's overall, I just like, I really love watching him play. It's entertaining, man. And he see the whole floor. You know, the game is like, it's like it's changing so much, but I don't know. Like I said, he's so young. We got a long way to go, but I think this is a good start right here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Did you play basketball?
Not really.
No?
She did. I go out there and play with him right now, you know, just for fun, but I haven't played since
gosh, you have.
Nah, he's just
why,
natural.
Why have your mom and your brother said that?
I used to play, but just for fun.
They said that she was good.
Oh, yeah? Maybe she just want to let you shine, you know? Maybe she just want to let you shine.
Yeah. So,
let me ask you this, King. This is let me ask mom. Mom.
Yeah.
How is he focused as a student?
He does good. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm not just saying as an academic student. Like, I guess the thing is how coachable. Like, is he how?
Okay.
I'm very coachable. She doesn't have to answer.
Okay. He's coachable. What can I say? I don't know. We had a little issue, which is like
Since we don't
talk about school, I'm talking about being coachable. I'm talking about being coachable. Let's go to the court for a little minute. Very coachable. But I needed him to pipe down a little bit.
Yeah.
If that makes sense. Coachable, but pipe it down a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, you don't know more than we know. We older than you. But yeah, he's coachable. Yeah.
I think
he had a long way to go though. But
yeah, King. Yeah. King, you're so talented. You're so talented and you're so skilled. You are the number one player in the country. And at the end of the day, it's not going to be a lot of players who probably are, there isn't, I mean, being number one says to me that you have the combination of athletic skills and IQ to execute and succeed at the highest level. Okay. So the one thing that you always want to make sure you keep in mind is that the people who are watching you play and who are invested in you, you know, unlike anybody else, who have your back and want to see you win and succeed. It's just sometimes that they are going to have the ability to probably see things from their chair on the sideline different, you know, but that's the reason why that's so important. And I'm not just saying that to you, but I'm also saying it to all the young kids that are watching you. Okay. They're watching you because you're the number one player. And because of that, they're watching this conversation. That's important for all kids to understand, you know, being coachable, just allowing yourself to be vulnerable and willing to let mom or dad or coach or whomever it is help guide you, you know, and using their experiences. It's a team, because it's a team sport at the end of the day. And the coach is the sixth player on the court. That's how you know, they have the ability to see things from a distance. They can't get involved and do anything, but they can see it. So
yeah.
Let's play a little game, King. Let's play a little game to see where your head's at. We're going to talk about a few things, all right? You've already said KD over LeBron. You've already said that. So who would you pick, Kyrie or Steph?
Steph is the best point guard in the league.
What's the difference between Kyrie and Steph?
Steph Curry is a better basketball player.
Simple as that. Simple as that. That's tough, man.
How?
Hey, Steph's handles are nowhere near Kyrie's handles.
He won a championship without KD. He could have won a championship with KD.
Yeah. Kyrie got a championship with LeBron. He'll probably get one with KD. All
right. But he plays by himself.
Hey man, nobody does it. Nobody does it by themselves anymore. That's the reason why I go back to coachable though. You can't name a player that's won a championship by themselves. But I'll let you go with that.
Steph Curry didn't have a star player on his team when he won his championship. He got robbed for the MVP, the finals MVP.
Did you say he didn't have a star on his team?
He didn't have a star.
So Klay Thompson's not a star?
He's not a star like LeBron or Kevin Durant.
I got you. Okay. All right. Cool. All right. Has the doctor said how tall you're going to be? Because you kind of a tall guard, ain't you?
6'10".
6'10"?
7. I mean, the lowest is 6'8".
How tall are you right now?
5'2".
You 5'2" right now? Mm-hmm. Mom, did you hear the doctor say this?
Nah, he's gonna be tall. Yeah, me and dad alone. He ain't got no choice but to be tall. Straight
the kids are typically taller than their parents.
He's tall, I know. Yeah, and he is like super tall for 11 years old.
Yeah. Oh God, bless America. So yeah, keep watching KD.
Yeah, you play like KD. That's who you play.
Tell me about. So I think this is really cool, because for all the folks who's taking a listen to this conversation, like, not only is he a standout kid, I mean, as far as a player, but like between him and mom and dad, I don't know who's the creative vision behind it, but they out here, like, they right behind the Big Baller Brand, because they done created a brand like this. The boy got merch at his games. Let's talk about, is it King Collection?
King's Court
Collection?
Yeah.
Let's talk about that. How did that get in place?
Well, you know how, like, every court I step on, you know, I'm like, I'm the best. Like, every court I step on is my court, so King's Court. And, you know, like, when somebody steps on the court, I want somebody to feel like, hey, they're a king.
Okay. So, like, how much are you involved in behind this versus mom? Like, I mean, like, do you design, do you play in a role in, like, what you want your shorts or your shirts or your clothes to look like?
Oh, yeah. They'll ask me if I like it. And if I like it, I'll say yeah. But if I don't like it, I'm like, I think we could do better.
Yeah. Mom, let me ask you this. Like, how much do you learn from him? Just this generation of youth is going to be so different than anyone else, because they're so accustomed and different to change. Like, they know things about fashion that we just don't know yet.
Oh, no doubt.
So what do you learn from him in this process?
I mean, King is fashionably inclined to me. I don't know what everybody else thinks, but I think he, you know, he looked nice when he put his clothes on. So let's start there. He's into fashion. He loves to look nice and all of that, but along with him dominating on the court, already being number one and holding that spot, we were like, man, what else could we do? What else could we do to add to this? You know, we got to build from here. So I don't know. As far as fashion, I mean, he know what they're wearing out there, and him and his friends. So, you know, his opinion matters to us all day long.
Hey, I think that y'all need to build on that, because you're a good looking kid too. You know what I'm saying? You got the pretty hair and all that. I'm sure you gonna be a problem if you ain't already a problem. Mom and dad gonna have all little kind of little girls just aggravating. Okay, stay focused. Are you still telling mom and dad you don't like girls? You ain't telling them that no more.
I like girls.
See, my son be trying to be secretive. He's still trying. He's 9. He's still trying to act like, I don't know.
Yeah, him too. I need you to open up to me, though. You're going to have to talk to me sooner or later. I need him to talk to me, Randy. What's going on? What you doing in this room?
But y'all know, y'all got something. Y'all really have something. I mean, you're a good-looking kid, man. You might as well go and get on somebody's runway. Because you can take the hair out. Yeah. You can do whatever. You got a lot of options.
Yeah.
Speaking of, I'm going to plug this right now, because it's this week, RVA Fashion Week, October 4th through the 10th. Man, I don't know if they got any young kids on the bill, but you guys need to get King Collection Court in there. They focus on all Richmond-based regional brands, clothing, merchandise. You may want to look into that. Contact Jimmy Budd. Yeah, that would be a good look. So, what about sneakers? Like, is that coming in the pipeline anytime soon?
Yeah, that's in the plan.
I'm not
going
to say too much.
Oh, go, whoa, mama, he's media trained. He said we're not saying too much about the sneakers.
Don't give it all up at once. But
yeah, that's right.
No, we got slides. So the shoes, the sneakers, I'm hearing that a lot of his friends at school are even telling him, King, you need to get you some shoes and put King's Court on the bottom and all that. So I'm like, you know, a lot of his friends, I keep telling King, that's where you need to start right there with your friends. You know, your friends, they need to get the gear, they need to wear it. All the players you play with, that's where it started. So to me, when I'm around them, Randy, I'd be tripped out, but they'd be like, King, you need some shoes, King. King, I think you should get some shoes. And it's like, they right, King, they right. You don't think they right, King?
I don't.
Nah, it's coming though,
it's not my fault.
No, it's coming. We got time though, Randy.
You got plenty of time. You got plenty of time.
King's gonna be a little model and all that. He's gonna be all that.
Yeah, man, just keep doing what you're doing, man, and continue to listen to your parents. And the sky really is the limit for you. I'm really, I just want to say, as a old man, I'm really proud to see, you know, a kid in my own area that's the number one player in the country. And it's going to be really exciting to just kind of watch your journey and path. You know, one day you're going to be 20 years old and you're going to be in the NBA. And this little footage from when you was 11 years old is going to circulate around. You know, I mean, it's just the truth of the journey that you're going to be on. And so just continue to stay focused, man.
Your son into sports?
You know, I ruined my son. I don't know what I did. So I had my son. I mean, I'm a junkie. I'm a gym junkie. All right. Okay. I was in the gym. I had my son, the water boy, on the middle school team at Providence when he was three.
For real?
Because he was too young to play.
Okay.
So then at four, he was able to play, and he played up until last year, right before COVID.
Right.
But I don't know. I think that I probably would have benefited, and he would have benefited from letting someone else coach him.
I guess.
So right now, my son's like more into Cub Scouts and that type thing, just because.
I guess.
I was like, put it this way, my parents whose kids love to play.
Yeah.
Love me, the parents do too. It was hard. It was hard for my son probably to play for me because I was just too serious.
Okay.
I probably
and
scared. You
know what? It's so crazy to hear you say that. Too serious. Elaborate on that a little bit, though. Like,
say that again.
Elaborate on your too serious. What you mean?
You know, I mean, I didn't make it to the NBA, but I had a good little run. But like, basketball for me, it's changed my life. I mean, okay. I wouldn't have been able to go to college or anything if it wasn't basketball. So like, I take basketball serious when it comes to practice and everything of life. I don't believe in certain things, sitting on balls, kicking balls. I'm really big on discipline and respect. And, you know, if you don't want to play, I don't think you should be out there. You know, you got a lot of parents that get their kids involved with sports because they want them to learn like social skills and meet friends and just have something to do. And that's right. Cool. Go to I-9 for that.
I know. I'm with you, Randy. Oh,
go to I-9
God.
For that.
We can turn this conversation up a little notch more, but I don't want nobody to get mad. But you're right, though. I'm with you. I think we all feel you on that.
Yeah, so that's kind of where for my son, you know, I probably took the fun away from it because my son really just wanted to have fun. And
I guess.
But I'm hopeful that he'll come back around because it's in his blood and he's gonna be he's tall.
Right. Right.
So I hope he comes back around with it.
Okay. Yeah, I'm with you, though, Randy. Like we big on the respect thing. Just remaining humble. I know that can get up under your skin. Sometime being number one, but just remaining humble. And I always try to tell King how many of his peers really do look up to him. You know, I mean.
Oh, yeah. You do recognize really, you're a leader, right?
Yeah, you have to really play that role and know, you know, you're different. You know what I'm saying? You're different and you really got to know, like, Yeah, eyes are on you at all times.
Yeah, man. Hey, can you know more people know you than you know?
Yeah, that's true.
Because you're the number one player in the country.
Yeah.
But hey, before we transition here and close, King, you got to give me a little bit of game, okay? Give me a little bit of game in regard to, like, what are kids your age right now listening to when it comes to music?
Oh. Lil Baby, best rapper.
Lil Baby, is he the best rapper? Give me your top five.
Lil Baby,
I'm
starting from one. Lil Baby's number one. Lil Durk is number two. Drake is number three. Who else? I can't think of other.
That's the three that matter. You don't like Da Baby?
He's number 10. Number nine.
Okay.
Number nine-ish. Number
okay. 10. You didn't name any female artists. What female artists do you like right now, hip-hop artists?
Can't think of no females you like. Nope. I don't.
So you don't like Sweetie or
Sweetie.
Am I saying her name right?
She's okay. She's
not. You don't like Cardi B?
Cardi B is number 7.
Dang, man.
She's number 8.
Let me tell you what, man. When you number one in the country, it's hard for anybody to be top anything with you.
Oh, right?
You're
gonna
be hard. Hardcore.
Hardcore.
So let me ask you this. Would it be a dream come true to see your brother get drafted to the Golden State Warriors? Because you said you like Steph Curry. Yeah?
I want to meet Steph Curry.
Have you met him yet?
Nope.
You will soon. Trust me. You'll meet him very soon. It will say, at the rate you're going, you might get a chance to play against him. Who knows?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, he's been in the presence of a lot of NBA players already. Took pictures with him, been around him at different arenas, different places, different gyms. And, you know, like we just rooting for our son, my son and his older brother. Really get there, man. It's been a journey, and I don't know. I'm just excited. I'm excited for it all. I mean, I'm just blessed to be a part of it all. To be real with you, man. But yeah, he's been in the presence of a few NBA players, but he ain't met Curry yet. We gotta get that. We gotta make that happen.
I mean, Russell Westbrook.
Yeah, man. Russell Westbrook is a ant. He's a dog. I love Russell Westbrook.
Yeah.
Again, we can't say enough, man, to take our hat off to you and just your whole family. I mean, you're doing something great. I mean, you know, think you could have your brother could be in the NBA, and one day you could also be right behind him. Imagine your sister might go to WNBA. That could all happen. That is a real thing that could happen. So just recognize right now that you are part of something bigger than yourself. As good as you are part of something really big. God has blessed you, you know, and we just want to see you continue to do well. What's your favorite shoes?
Kobe's.
Yep. Kobe was my favorite player because I'm a Laker fan too, but when Kobe came into the NBA, he was like my favorite player from when he came until when he dropped the mic. Anything you want to share before we get off here and close? Anything we can expect coming from you? Like, anything you want to predict?
Me dunking on Mondo.
You dunking on who?
Lil Mondo. Armondo.
Oh, your brother? Can you touch the backboard?
Close. I'm right here.
Okay. You got a long way to go before you're going to be beating your brother, man.
Yeah. I'm right there. I'm right there.
Do you really talk this much junk to him?
Yes, he do. They talk junk to each other.
How does he respond? Does he take you serious?
Yeah, but like, it's true.
Oh, man.
I'm like, be nice for once, King.
Hey, you know what, though? Hey, I guess that's just the competitive nature that's in you.
All day long.
So you keep that, man. You keep that. For all of King Court Collection friends, listen, this podcast will be played everywhere that podcasts are. You can go check this podcast out also on randywilsonpodcast.com. I suggest you guys go over to YouTube, though, and the IndieTube, so then you can see the young man and put a face with him. Google him. He's all over the internet. You can find all kind of highlight films and videos. You can also find him at, is it underscore King?
Underscore the King 5.
On Instagram. So you can go find him there as well. And I want to say, but I'm not going to say, but I will say, listen, continue to listen to the Randy Wilson podcast. We got some big news coming soon. I don't want to break it yet, but you'll soon be hearing Randy Wilson podcast on some radio station. I don't know exactly which one it's going to be yet. Stay tuned, because we're getting ready to expand ourselves a little bit. So thank you, Miss Joya, for allowing me to talk to your son.
Okay. You know,
fine, young man.
Appreciate
you. For all of those folks, make sure you subscribe to the Randy Wilson podcast. I'm like 7 or 8 away from 1,000. Okay. I've been saying this for like 3 months.
Oh, it's coming.
So maybe the young people will help me get over the top here. All right. But King, you started something, man, because I got to now follow up with a few other young folks. So I think I might go on a pathway here where I sit and talk to, I got to talk to Manny's daughter, Timani Harris. She's one of the top players in the country as well.
Timani is lit.
Yep.
Timani lit.
Yep. And I've been good friends with the Kistner family for over 10 years. I know Huey Stone, he just left and went to, he just left Team Marsh to go to, what is that team? It's a popular team. Team Loaded, I think. So, yeah, I'm gonna start talking to the young folks, so y'all can give me game about Lil Baby and all that stuff. All right, King. We're gonna sign out here. This podcast, we'll have this out here in about it start seeing clips on Instagram anytime within the next week. All right. All right. Thank you, brother.
Okay, Ryan.
Have a good night.
Okay.